Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. And on this video, we will be going to an Indian store nearby and we'll be checking out the stock that they have. We'll see if all the things that would be required on a monthly basis can be found there. So stay tuned. This is one of the Indian stores called the Indian Supermart. So let us take a brief tour about how an Indian store in Adelaide looks like. So as soon as you enter, you will have this fresh vegetable section to your right hand side, and you have almost all of the most commonly used ones available here on stock and always fresh. And as soon as you enter into the store, you will have these aisles that are made up that have pretty much everything that one would want in an entire month's, you know, cooking or grocery demands. So to the very first left side of the aisle, you will see that you have cosmetics, pretty much all the Indian brands. If you are very selective and you would only choose brands like Himalaya or Patanjali, you could definitely find them here in Adelaide. In fact, in most of the stores across Australia. And then you have the tea and all the biscuits that one would opt to have for breakfast. To the right, you would also find all sorts of ready-to-eat items from companies like Kemcho, Ching's, Gits and MTR. I think these are pretty popular across Australia and a lot of students prefer to have these packets, and it's really pretty simple and helps with, you know, when you have university classes and things like that. As you move along the lane, you have papads, you have you know, the namkeen items that one would, you know, fancy having either with their soft drinks or otherwise. You have literally everything that you would get in India, and I think that just makes it easy, especially when you move here and the first couple of weeks are really confusing and you are always troubled by what to eat and if you will be able to adjust to the cuisine here in Australia. So the best way to escape that is to just come to any Indian store and pick up one of these, and these are really you know, handy and pretty filling as well. Maybe not the most healthy option, but it does help you with your first couple of weeks as soon as you move here. So this is perhaps the most important section. This is the place where most of the rice is stocked. So if you can see, these are all pretty familiar brands. India Gate, you have Dawat, and you have India, which is probably only sold overseas. And I think this is perhaps one of the best that I have tried recently. It's by a brand called Zeba. And this is the second aisle now. So you'll have salt, you'll have oils, you'll have jaggery that are pretty much, again, pretty, you know, staple kind of in Indian style of cooking. You have all kinds of oils available here. You have the mustard oil, you have vegetable oil as well. And probably the most famous kind of oil that's used in most of India's cooking is sunflower oil, and there are multiple brands which offer this at different prices, but the one that we prefer to use is either Katumba, or if that's not available, we go ahead with another brand called Dhara, which is here, but not the this variant, the other variant, that's the sunflower oil. And in the upper part of the aisle here, on the rack, you'll see all kinds of lentil and peas. And I think there are more options in these here than in India, because I'd never seen so many variety of lentils and peas in India. And I discovered a lot of them only when I came here. As you can see, you have black eye beans, you have the masoor dal and masoor gota, and this is adzuki bean. I don't know what it is called in Hindi though. And this is chickpea, Tyson. This is basically the kala chana, the desi chana that we have in India. Yeah, this one, desi chickpea. And this is a parachute oil. I think for all the South Indian guys, you will get this here, so you don't have to worry about it, because when I moved here, I was pretty worried. Although we don't necessarily use it in cooking, but it's a very important part of our you know, grooming and healthcare routine. So this is a must go. And as we move along, we have the next part of this aisle that has the masalas and the spices section basically. And from the direction which I'm walking, you'll first come across pickles, a lot of options, mango, lemon, mixed veggie, you name it, you have all the options. And to the other side, you have the chutneys, you have all the amchoos and vada pav masala that, you know, if you are really someone who likes cooking those things at home, you could very well do that. All the ingredients are basically of the nature of being a blend of both homemade and restaurant, you know, kind of flavoring and things like that. So these are all essences that you'll get. I think it's sufficient if you are here by yourself. I think if you visit an Indian store once, you'll get a month's worth of grocery all at once. You don't have to worry. You don't have to go to multiple shops to get things. You'll have all of the things available. I think this is the most important section, especially for guys who like to cook by themselves and eat, you know, only because it's so much more healthier and cost effective. So you have the coriander powders, the cumin powders, and you also have the whole seeds of them. You have the pepper seeds, pepper powder, you have whole chili. So it's a heaven for someone who really enjoys cooking and also pretty cost effective. If you're here as a student, it can be difficult at times, especially when you don't have a job for yourself and you're entirely dependent on the funds that you receive from India. And to this side, you have the sauces, you have the chutneys, and I think this is a pretty elaborate collection. If you just have a look at it, you have, I think this is, you know, a brand that is available only in Australia. I'm not sure if it's there in New Zealand or Canada, but you'll also get Maggi. You'll have you know, all kinds of flavors available. You have the bhel puri and coriander chutney as well. So I think it's a, you know, pretty good collection. And interestingly, you also have the signature tomato ketchup by Maggi. So I think, you know, if you're someone who enjoys Maggi noodles and also like to add a bit of sauce or ketchup, you are done. You are set for your breakfast and snacks. And this is perhaps the most important part of the spices section, because you have all MDH collection. You have, I think you'll also get Everest and all the other leading brands in India, because most of them export, and that's how they are so easily accessible here as well. And this is one of the most commonly used, you know, paste, ginger garlic paste. All of the students that I know from India, they use this mandatorily in their dishes. So I think, you know, you could try that. So you have MDH and a huge collection of MDH spices, as well as Everest and a lot of options that they are. I think the most, you know, commonly used out of all these is Everest Pav Bhaji. I think it's the best. I personally love it. So I think you could definitely experiment with your cooking skills. And now in the final aisle, you have ghee and butter options. And I think it's, I don't know if you guys are familiar with the brands, but Nanak is a brand that is, I think, based out of Canada. Yeah, see, it's made in Canada, and it's pretty popular there as well. And Britannia also is something that's preferred a lot. And as you move along, you have some sweets which are ready to eat and popularly buy Haldiram's. There are some other brands that operate in the same space. And then finally, we have, I think, the last solid food related section, that is the flour section. You have all kinds of atta. You have bhakri atta, that's a bit of porous, and you have makki ka atta, you have maida, you have dhokle ka atta, you have sabudana as well. So there are a lot of options that one has, and you don't have to be worried if you'll have to get them here when you're moving for the first time. You literally have everything that you would need to make any kind of largely Indian style cuisine. So I think these are all the flour options that we have. You have bajre ka atta, we have ragi da atta, and so many of them. And then finally, I think this is going to feature as one of the most important things when you move abroad to study, be it in Australia, Canada, New Zealand, US, so wherever, you will have to learn how to make rotis if you want to be cost effective. And I think Ashirwad, brands like Pillsbury are things that you will get everywhere. So you can be rest assured, but just make sure that you learn how to cook. And this is again a bit of stock. And this is the final section. These are the frozen options that we have. Frozen parathas, frozen rotis. This is pretty handy for people who have early morning classes or have part-time work shifts in the morning. You also get a lot of frozen style veggies here. I think the most popular brands are Ashoka and Wadilal. I also like Wadilal chilies that we use. It's more or less fresh. You have literally all kinds of vegetables, from drumstick to peas. Bhindi also. Bhindi is labeled as okra here. You have pretty much all kinds of vegetables in frozen aisles as well. And there you have the fresh vegetable section. And this fridge here, it stocks idli batters, it stocks dosa batters and chutneys and sweets and paneer. Oh, momo, I saw this for the first time. So you have paneer, both in fried and fresh paneer cubes. So there's a lot of option. If you are someone who enjoys getting stuff, cooking at home, it has its own benefit. It saves a lot of money as well. And this is the curd collection yogurt, Indian style yogurt. If you go to stores like Woolworths or Kohl's, you will have Greek style yogurt as well, but Indian style yogurt you'll only find in Indian stores. So I think these are pretty, so there are different sizes in buckets. It depends on how many people stay that you could choose to take. This one probably suits for one or two people. And this one is something that I take all the time. That's a 2 kg tub. And this one's a 5 kg tub. I don't prefer that because it does not fit in the fridge. So depending on the size of your fridge and the number of people that you stay together, you should decide taking the one that suits you the most. So in this segment, we'll be talking to the owner of the place, Mr. Raj. And he's been very kind. He's let us come into the store and shoot at a really busy hour of the day, especially on a weekend. So thank you, Raj, again for this opportunity. So the question to you is, what is the most common demand that most of the Indian international students have? And if in case there are things that are not available on shop, how do you manage to get them? So that's like the biggest question that anyone would have.
Yep.
So, and how long does that take for you to procure them? Is it a week? Is it lesser than that? Whatever. So if you could just enlighten us on that.
So for students, like they're looking for something which is, which doesn't require that much cooking. And for that, it will be like a lot of ready to eat items, a lot of frozen items as well. So okay, those are the two things which you can say it's like pretty fast moving for the students. Apart from that, like they might also be looking for a lot of like drinks, depending upon which season it is.
Yeah.
So drinks, frozen items and ready to eat items would be the primary things for students, I would say. In terms of availability of these products, it depends. Like if the products are available, because we procure all our stock from the suppliers. So if something is available with a local supplier, we might be able to get it within a week.
Mm-hmm.
If it is not, then it might take up to 3 months, because that's the time it takes for products to come from India
okay.
to here. So that's the import time.
Okay, so now that we are talking about the most demanded food item or grocery item on the list for students, I think the most commonly demanded would also be Maggi at times.
Yep.
Do you have instances where Maggi noodles is out of stock?
So we've been in business for about 7 months, and Maggi noodles is something like which will never go out of stock. It's not only like a special thing for our store. It's no matter which store or which area it is. Businesses also look at, like, you know, what is their fastest moving item, and they try to secure the stock whenever it is available, so that the customers don't go back. Because otherwise, like, you can even ask, like, any student or any person who comes in and asks for Maggi noodles, if the store owner has to reply that it's not available, the reputation will be completely destroyed. So we have to look after those kind of things.
So Raj, as we were discussing about how long does it generally take for, say, a stock to come to your place, like from the supplier, Are you experiencing any delays, particularly because of the whole COVID situation?
It's getting better compared to last year, but I think it's still, the supply chains are currently affected to an extent when it comes to the FMCG sector, because a lot of these things actually come with a specific shelf life. So because of COVID, currently what we are experiencing is, like, by the time the product reached to our shelves, it has already gone past like 2 months into the lead time, into the shelf life. So that is like, we'll have to be more careful around procuring all these products, because otherwise by the time it reaches to the customer, they might only have to, like, you know, consume that product in 2 or 3 months, which might not be practical for small families. So COVID is affecting, like, not only the business side, but every single person in the supply chain in the same way.
Yeah, that's a problem with the whole COVID situation. Us students have been not able to travel to our home countries as well. So that's a bit of a restriction. But the good news is, whenever you are moving to Australia, especially to Adelaide, you have a lot of options here. You have, you know, a lot of stores that will have the things that you are definitely looking for. And the one-stop location that I prefer the most is right here on Henley Beach Road. So do check out the link in the description and do mark them as your favorite place for all your Indian grocery-related items.